Okay, we're going to continue. From Dayton, Ohio, his third appearance on Def Comedy Jam. Listen to this name. I love this name. 100% Brother Maestro. Come on, let's hear it.
Alright. First of all, for those that ain't hip, let me introduce myself properly. I'm Maestro to 100, M-Y-S to the T-R-O. Ask your great-grandmama if you don't know. That type shit. I'm the original 100% brother, and you just don't become 100% nigga. You got to go through levels. And since I'm the original 100, I'm here to teach the motherfuckers that need to know. The 50% is who I'm talking about. Because there's some 50% of motherfuckers in here because I can smell them. Them the niggas with half the knowledge they supposed to have always fucking shit up for the rest of us. All right. They be following me around the country trying to sneak in my seminar and decipher my shit. Try to take it back to 50% headquarters and break the code. All right. I went in a club a couple weeks ago, got a grown ass man sitting in the club wearing a tuxedo in the bathroom handing people shit. I'm looking at this nigga like, nigga, what happened? What the fuck? You should have stayed awake in high school, nigga. What happened? How you get a job handing out shit in the bathroom? Wearing a tuxedo. Nigga, don't nobody care if you dressed up for this shit. Then the nigga trying to be too goddamn helpful. I'm on the toilet. This nigga sticking paper under the door and shit. Like, goddamn. Like, nigga, beat it. Been shitting by myself since I was 2. Beat it. Damn, this nigga had so much shit on the counter, I thought I walked into a nigga's house. He got cologne, peanuts, big ass bowl of Halloween candy and shit. You know, so I'm on my way back to the club, cause you know the 100, I like to keep my breath tight. I take one of the nigga mints, right? He over in the corner. I'm like, nigga, what? That'll be $1. Like, nigga, this the bathroom. Ain't nobody buying nothing to eat in the goddamn bathroom. I be done caught hepatitis eating some shit in here. Who the fuck told you to set up a snack shop in the toilet any goddamn way? Damn. Nigga, take your mint. Fucking around, you know the 100. I ain't having it. Bullshit. Damn. Some motherfuckers just be lunching though with the job, man. And then they be trying to put bullshit on TV like we stupid and shit. I was watching some shit the other day. Y'all see that shit that was on Fox called When Animals Attack? Woo! Nigga! I called the network and ordered the tape. That shit was comedy! Y'all see the lady that got attacked by the bear? Nigga, for those of y'all that didn't see it, I got to reenact this shit. That shit. Motherfuckers, some motherfuckers, you know, I ain't no prejudice, motherfucker. Hold up. Hold up, though. Hold up. We can talk about that shit later. I got to hurry up. You know, there wasn't no brothers getting attacked on that motherfucker. Because we don't be fucking with animals. That's white people trying to be Tarzan and shit. They at the zoo with their hand all up in the cage trying to get the bear to come over to their monkey ass. The bear and they're like, bitch, read the sign. Don't fuck with me. Damn. You gone. I don't want to take no picture. Gone. And as soon as the bear snatched their ass up in the cage, they got the bear in court on some trumped up charges and shit. Like, Yana, what I'm supposed to do, right? She got her hand all up in the nigga face, right? Taunting the motherfucker up, per se, if you will, Yana. You know? This motherfucker, the lady though, she's sitting in the TV studio, right? She got on her little Sunday go to meeting dress, right? She had the shit up to the neck. She got her eyes closed. Nigga, that's a problem because it was a bear right here. 7 feet. A nigga would have been watching a bear like this. All right, she's sitting there with her eyes closed, just happy. The bear trainer over here, this motherfucker got on a karate suit. Nigga, strike one. Because obviously he expected some trouble in this motherfucker. You know, he know the bear ain't friendly and shit. Then he got little ass chain on the bear like he walking a chihuahua or some shit. He feeding the bear Scooby snacks and shit. And the bear was chilling at first. He was happy to be on TV. Like, what's up, nigga? Smokey Smoke. Nigga, yeah. Nigga, I done came up. Nigga, fuck that circus. I done came up. Shit. You know, he was eating. And just to show you how smart animals are, before he attacked the lady, he turned around and looked at her ass. That motherfucker stopped eating. He was like, bitch, I'm about sick of you. That motherfucker turned back around, put his hand in his bear pocket and shit. Then he just turned around and stole on her ass. She was like, something ain't right. Something ain't right. Something ain't right. God damn. And the cameraman didn't stop. That motherfucker was like, see, this is fucked up. This how motherfuckers get killed right here. This don't make no kind of sense. Damn. Nigga. But the saddest part, though, the saddest part was Peanut, the African elephant. Because he was trying to escape from the circus. That motherfucker was a true African going for his freedom. I felt for that nigga. You know, he was tired of doing tricks for the white man and shit. It was like he was on the phone with Minister Farrakhan before the show. He's like, what? I'm supposed to be getting paid for this shit? Oh, it's going to be some changes tonight. Yeah. Yeah, nigga, watch the news. Peanut going off in this motherfucker. Yeah. Yeah. No. No, I ain't having it. Fuck the big top, nigga. Fuck the big top. Man, that little motherfucker with the Elvis jumpsuit smacked Peanut in the knee. Peanut picked that motherfucker and was like, ugh! Then he came down with the headbutt, pow, nigga, yeah! Then the white people started running, right? Because they knew that wasn't part of the show, right? The niggas was sitting there like, that shit was tight! That shit was tight! Damn, that motherfucker really looked hurt too, yo! Man, white people running, and Peanut being a true African, right? He looking around like, okay, now my chance to sneak out and blend in with these motherfuckers, right? This nigga running down the street with the people. He got his toenails painted, big ass hat on, trying to act like he wasn't an elephant killing motherfuckers. Like, it's an elephant back there fucking people up. Yo, 100% a maestro, Peace.